I am Dr. Sanjay Pudnar. I am going to present research paper on socio-economic development of primitive tribal groups in Nashik district. I have present the origin of research problems. In Maharashtra, there are 47 tribes. In Maharashtra, tribal population is mainly concentrated in 15 district, but the tribal communities are spread over all over the district out of 47 tribes. Three tribes, tribal groups have been categorized as primitive tribal groups. They are Kola, Madiyagon and Katkai. These tribes are concentrated in the following districts: Madiyagon in Gadchiroli, Kola in Yodmal and Chandrapur, and Katkari in the Nashik district. These communities are declared as primitive tribal groups because of following reasons. First reason is pre-agricultural level technology. Second is low level of literacy. Literacy is only 14%. Then third is stagnant or diminishing population. As the majority of tribal lives in the remote forest area, they are remained isolated and untouched by civilization. They are largely unaffected by development process. Therefore, the groups remain backward, particularly in health, poverty, malnourished, employment, self-employment, education, infant mortality rate, deprivation, basic amenities like housing, water supply sanitation, electricity and socio-economic aspects. Next, a definition of tribes. Devar Commission has explained the scheduled tribes. The scheduled areas and tribe commission were known popularly Devar Commission. It classified scheduled tribes in India, those living in urban stage, those in soil shifting cultivation, and those are in a regular agriculture, those who have already in assimilation in mainstream. Tribals are called Vanyajati, Adimjamati, Janjati, Bhumiputra, Vanyavashi and Girijanvishu. Study region. The research study region is only Nashik district. The total population in the Nashik district according to 2011 census 61 lakh. Out of that, 25.61% tribal population has found, and PTG population only 0.65%. Objective of the proposed research: to study the human development indicator among primitive tribal groups in the Nashik district. Then next is to understand the socio, educational, economic and health dimension of the tribal development in the Nashik district. Then next is to hear some scheme for the upliftment of village people. This would give some guidelines to people planning strategy. And last is to suggest theoretical as well as practical suggestion to study the concept of human development indicators among the primitive tribal groups in the Nashik district. Data sources: primary and secondary data used in this research. Then methodology: I have used the various methods such as social development index, human development index, index of concentration, volume of change, then GIS techniques will be used in mapping, then population growth rate, various methods we have used in these research papers. Then sampling of research, we have selected 7 tehsils out of 15 tehsils, total PTG families 750.
Good morning all of you. Myself Jagdish Dagdu Vetal, research scholar from Department of Geography, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Marathwada University, Aurangabad. One day international conference on recent trend in geography in associated with Maharashtra Bhugol Shastra Parishad, Pune, 20th March 2021. My research topic is healthcare services in tribal tehsil of Nashik district. First introduction. With 8.86%, the tribal population in India has considered it impossible to cross the healthcare divide between the tribal and non-tribal communities. There are socially and culturally poorer and also living in an agricultural economy and generalized backwardness under the objects poverty. This is due to their poor health and is source of suffering and result of it. The study area, the Nashik district consists of 15 tehsils, namely Malegaon, Nandgaon, Nashik, Nifad, Pet, Baglan, Sinnar, Surgana, Trambakeshwar, Chandwad, Devla, Dindori, Igatpuri, Kalwan and Evla. The Nashik district is located at an altitude of 600 meters above mean sea level. These tribal tehsils are the my studies mainly focused on tribal tehsil of Nashik district, like as a Dindori, Kalwan, Pet, Surgana and Trambakeshwar. Why this area is choose for the research paper? Because of this tribal tehsil are the poorer and access to health services is becoming more difficult as the road non-existence, lack of transport facilities and also ambulance services. The objective of this study area, the find out the availability and adequacy of healthcare services in study area. The second is the search causes analysis of healthcare services in tribal areas. And third one is that to develop and improve the framework of healthcare services for the tribal population. The methodology and data analysis for the study. The current research work is based on the secondary data sources such as a socio-economic abstract of Nashik district from 1981 to 2019. The tehsil is taken as the unit to determine the level of healthcare facilities in the field of research. The tehsil has scheduled tribe population known as a tribal tehsil for more than 50% of its total population. This criteria derived from the direction given by Government of India in 1975 and 76. The discussion, we will discuss on the healthcare services and number of patients because of the much of the India's tribal peoples live in hilly terrain areas where it is difficult to access healthcare services systems to reach them. First is healthcare services. The given table, the growth, the decade, hospitals, dispensaries, maternity home, primary health centers, sub-primary health centers, doctor, nurses and beds. The study duration 1981 to 2019. The given table, the growth to number of doctors, nurses and beds increased in each decade. The number of dispensaries declining after 2001 because of many dispensaries converting PSC and hospitals. During the study area or during the study period, the number of PSC subcenters, doctor, nurses and beds have been increased in given table. The pie diagram shows the government health services in tribal areas 1981, 1991, 2001, 2011 and 2019. The next is the number of patients. Two types of patients. First is indoor patient and second is outdoor patients. Same duration 1981 to 2019. During the study period compared to the outdoor patient services, the gain of internal facilities was much smaller in given table. It is also known as the number of patients accessing medical services is continuously dropping due to the individual private hospitals and the new facilities. The same diagram, pie diagram, the number of patients. Last is the conclusion. The rise in public healthcare services have impressive but unequal in the study duration in case of PSC nurses, bed and even physicians. This growth is fast in tribal areas. There is a substantial decline in number of clinics, maternity homes and pharmacies as these have been moved in either PSC or hospitals. Next is findings. It's found that the health services in this tribal region have almost improved. The number of doctors, nurses, physicians and beds saw a rise. Second, the lack of budget for medicine, lack of physical facilities in PSC centers. Third, the number of patients who have been benefited from the medical services, the gain of internal facilities was much smaller. And last is one, policy measure. The demographic criteria proposed by Bohr Committee or National Health Plan in 1983 for delay healthcare services should be enforced. According to the 2011 census, the population was Dindori Tehsil has 3,15,709 lakh and the specification, the Dindori Tehsil has required 16 primary health center as per government rule, but it now has only 10 primary health center as per rule. But in future, more PSC should be built in this area. Thank you so much.
Dear friends, good morning to all. I am Dr. V.B. Kale, working as assistant professor in the Department of Geography, KTHM College, Nasik. Dear friends, today I am going to present the paper entitled Capability of Sugarcane Production in Dindori Tehsil, Nasik District, Maharashtra. So let us see the location of my study area. This is the map of Maharashtra, which is in the blue color, and towards north there is the Nasik district, and near about middle of the Nasik district there is the Dindori Tehsil, which is red in color. And so I am presenting over here the suitability or capability of sugarcane production in Maharashtra. If we focus the light on the history or the production of sugarcane in Dindori Tehsil, then we come to know that in 2015-16 there is a 268,093 ton sugarcane crushing was there, and the recovery was 11.20%, and the rate in this year given by the factory, that is 2,214. From 2015 to 2020-21, we come to know that there is an increase in the production per year, and as well as there is an increase in the recovery rate also. That is 11.20. Here, up to some extent, it is a decrease of the recovery, but afterwards it is again increase, slightly decrease, and again it is increase in this year. So, if you see the rate per ton given by the factory, that is also increasing continuously from 2,214. Now, in the last year, they have given the rate, that is 2,736. What it indicates? It indicates that the rate of sugarcane is increased every year, and it is the indicator of the development of the factory. Means production, recovery and rate is continuously increasing, which indicates the development of factory in the last 5-6 years. So this is the these are the dams which are available in the Dindori Tehsil. There are major 6 dams which are available in Dindori Tehsil. First one is Karanjwan Dam, which have 21 TMC capacity, storage capacity, and another dams are also there which are small as compared to the Karanjwan Dam. That is Punegaon, Ozarkhed, Palkhed, Tisgaon and Waghad. So what it indicates, there is a main issue for the production of sugarcane, that is availability of the water. And these 5 dams mostly filled by the water every year, filled by the rainfall every year, and that's why there is a fulfillment of the water to the sugarcane production. So these dams are nothing but the indicator of the development and capability of the sugarcane production in Dindori Tehsil. If you see the physiography, we come to know that average height of Dindori Tehsil is 500 Minsi level, and most of the region is plateau. As we know that the mountainous region is not favorable so far the cultivation or the agricultural practices are concerned, but the except the western part of Dindori Tehsil, most of the part, particularly eastern part, is of plateau, and that's why there is a suitability or a favorable condition so far the agricultural production or particularly the sugarcane production is concerned. If we see the soils of the Dindori Tehsil, most of the soil is alluvial, because as we know that Dindori Tehsil is the part of Deccan Plateau or the some part of Sahyadrian ranges, but most of the part is alluvial soils. At the same time, some soils are black while as some soils are red, and these three soils are too much favorable for the production of sugarcane, and that's why there is a huge scope for the production of sugarcane. If we see the climate of Dindori Tehsil, there is a sufficient rainfall and pleasant temperature or suitable temperature for the production of sugarcane, and that's why climate is also suitable for the production of sugarcane in Dindori Tehsil. If we see the drainage system, there is a main river, that is Kadwa River. Kadwa River is the main tributary of the Godavari River, which flows from west to east and meets to the Godavari River at Nandur Madhyameshwar. Another sub tributaries or the tributaries of Kadwa Rivers are there, Unanda, Parashari and Kolwan River, which flows from Dindori Tehsil and helpful for the irrigation purpose, and that's why the suitability or the capability of sugarcane production is too much good in this region. Availability of water, most of the canals, particularly Ozarkhed Dam and Karandwan Dam, as well as Wagar Dam, also have the facility of the canals, which provides irrigation system to the fields, particularly sugarcane fields. Not only canals, but wells and tube wells are also in good number in this Dindori Tehsil, and that's why this availability, which makes the availability of water to the sugarcane production. If we see the distance of factory from the raw material, then we can get the idea that most of the raw material is available in between 15 kilometers. That's why it is there is no more expenses on the transportation cost, and that's why which minimize the transportation cost and which helpful for the production of the sugarcane, and it may benefit FCL for the farmers as well as for the sugar industry. Thus, if we see all these things which are available for the production of sugarcane in the Dindori Tehsil, then we come to know thus all these above factors are favorable for the production of sugarcane, which indicates the capability of sugarcane production is good. So all these favorable factors supports to the production's productivity and capability of the sugarcane, and that's why overall condition of the capability of the sugarcane production is good in Dindori Tehsil. So this is all about what I wanted to express. Thank you very much.
सर्वप्रथम माझा सर्वांना मनपूर्वक नमस्कार. मी प्राध्यापक डॉक्टर राजाराम महादेव थोरात, भूगोल विभाग प्रमुख, दग तटकरे कला व वाणिज्य महाविद्यालय तळा, तालुका तळा, जिल्हा रायगड. माझ्या पेपरचे नाव आहे रायगड जिल्ह्यातील पर्यटन स्थळांचा अभ्यास. रायगड जिल्ह्यात हिरवेगार वनराई, स्वच्छ व सुंदर निसर्गरम्य सागर किनारे, तसेच मुरुड, जंजिरा, कुलाबा हे जलदुर्ग महाराष्ट्राच्या शौर्याची साक्ष देत आहेत. रायगड, तळेगड, कर्नाळा, द्रोणागिरी हे किल्ले इतिहास प्रसिद्ध आहेत. अष्टविनायकापैकी पालीचा श्री बल्लाळेश्वर, मढचा वरदविनायक आणि दक्षिण काशी म्हणून प्रसिद्ध असलेले श्री क्षेत्र हरिहरेश्वर तसेच कनकेश्वर, नागेश्वर ही धार्मिक तीर्थक्षेत्रे आहेत. घारापुरी, कुडे, ठाणाळे, खडसांबळे, पाळे, महाड, कोल, आंबेवली या रायगड जिल्ह्यातील जगप्रसिद्ध बौद्ध लेण्या आहेत. तसेच माथेरान हे एक थंड हवेचे ठिकाण असून खांदेरी, उंदेरी, घारापुरी ही पुरातन बेटे आहेत. त्यामुळे दरवर्षी हजारो देशी व विदेशी पर्यटक रायगड जिल्ह्यात पर्यटनासाठी येतात. नैसर्गिक, सांस्कृतिक, ऐतिहासिक दृष्ट्या महत्व असल्यामुळे रायगड जिल्ह्यातील पर्यटन व्यवसायाचा विकास करणे गरजेचे आहे. लोकसंख्या संसाधनाच्या विकासामध्ये पर्यटन व्यवसायाला महत्व आहे. रायगड जिल्ह्याला 240 किलोमीटरचा नयनरम्य सागर किनारा लाभलेला आहे. रायगड जिल्ह्यात रायगड किल्ला हे महत्वाचे पर्यटन केंद्र आहे. पूर्वी हा किल्ला रायरिया नावाने ओळखला जात होता. छत्रपती शिवाजी महाराजांच्या हिंदवी स्वराज्याची राजधानी म्हणून रायगड किल्ला ओळखला जातो. नंतर मुरुड जंजिरा हा जलदुर्ग महत्वाचं पर्यटन केंद्र म्हणून जगप्रसिद्ध आहे. मुरुड जंजिरा किल्ला मुरुड तालुक्यात आहे. छत्रपती शिवाजी महाराज आणि त्यांचे सुपुत्र संभाजी महाराज यांनी जंजिरा जिंकण्याचा अनेक वेळा प्रयत्न केलेला होता. हा सागरी किल्ला संरक्षणाच्या दृष्टिकोनातून फारच महत्वाचा होता. माथेरान, माथेरान हे थंड हवेचे ठिकाण रायगड जिल्ह्यातील कर्जत तालुक्यात आहे. मुंबई आणि पुण्यापासून हे जवळ असल्यामुळे दरवर्षी हजारो पर्यटक या ठिकाणी भेट देत असतात. हरिहरेश्वर हे पर्यटन क्षेत्र दक्षिण काशी म्हणून जगप्रसिद्ध आहे. पेशवा बाळाजी विश्वनाथ भट यांचे हे जन्मगाव असून सागर सानिध्य व निसर्गरम्य परिसरामुळे अनेक पर्यटक या ठिकाणी गर्दी करतात. पाली, पाली व महड हे रायगड जिल्ह्यातील महत्वाची धार्मिक पर्यटन केंद्र आहेत. पालीजवळ उनेरे येथे गरम पाण्याचे झरे आहेत. अनेक त्वचारोग असणारे पर्यटक या ठिकाणी स्नान करण्यासाठी येत असतात. कुडे तळा या डोंगरी व दुर्गम तालुक्यात कुडा लेण्यांचा समावेश होतो. या लेण्यामध्ये 26 लेण्या आणि 11 पाण्याच्या टाक्यांचा समूह आहे. घारापुरी लेणी मुंबईच्या गेटवे ऑफ इंडियापासून 10 किलोमीटर अंतरावरती घारापुरी ही जगप्रसिद्ध लेणी असलेली दिसून येते. महाड, महाड शहर सावित्री व गांधारी नद्यांच्या संगमाजवळ असून डॉक्टर बाबासाहेब आंबेडकरांनी केलेल्या सत्याग्रहाने हे ठिकाण भारतभर पसरले. कुलाबा किल्ला हा अलिबाग तालुक्यात असून तो जगप्रसिद्ध आहे. त्या ठिकाणी भारताची भूचुंबकीय वेधशाळा असलेली दिसून येते. रायगड जिल्ह्यात भौगोलिक, ऐतिहासिक, धार्मिक पर्यटन स्थळे असून त्यापैकी महत्वाच्या पर्यटन स्थळांचा अभ्यास केलेला आहे. धन्यवाद.
Respected chairperson of this session, all dear participants, myself, Dr. S. D. Pagar, Associate Professor, Department of Geography, KTHM College, Nashik. I welcome all of you in this online one-day international conference on recent trend in geography, which is jointly organized by Maharashtra Bhugol Shastra Parishad Pune and Janta Shikshan Sanstha Kisan Veer Mahavidyalay Wai. In this conference, I am going to present my research paper on gender disparity in literacy in Maharashtra state of India. For this research purpose, I have selected two major objectives. The first objective is to highlight gender disparity in the literacy rate in the Maharashtra state. And second is to suggest some suitable measures to reduce the gender gap in literacy rate in the study area. That is, Maharashtra state is our study area. You know that Maharashtra state is agriculturally and industrially advanced state of India. It is located in the western part of India. For this research purpose, I have used the data and methodology. Data, all the data I have used, that is secondary type of data, which I have taken from the Census of India 2011. With respect to the methodology, I have calculated disparity index with respect to the literacy for this paper, and that formula I have used, which is given by Kundu and Rao in 1986. The formula is very simple, that is DI is equal to log into bracket x2 divided by x1 plus log into bracket 200 minus x1 divided by 200 minus x2. In this formula, we have DI stand for disparity index. X1 female literacy rate, x2 male literacy rate. Both rates are given in the percentage. And I have calculated the disparity index for 35 district of the Maharashtra. The whole disparity index, all disparity index for each and every district, it is ranging from 0 and between 0 and 1. In the first table, I have provided the information about the total literacy rate, male literacy rate, female literacy rate, and gender disparity index about the Maharashtra from 1961 to 2011. In the last column, you will see that in 1961, the gender disparity index was 0.39. It was reduced up to the 0.13 in 2011. This is the very important table. In this table, I have provided the information about the total literacy rate, female literacy rate, male literacy rate, and disparity index of all 35 districts of the Maharashtra. You will observe that Thane, Mumbai, Mumbai Suburban, Pune, Amravati, Wardha, Nagpur, these are the districts where gender gap in literacy is very less. In other hand, we have a district such as Gadchiroli, Hingoli, Parbhani, Jalna, Bid. Here you will observe that large, vast gender gap in the literacy rate. All these 35 districts, on the basis of literacy disparity index intensity, I have grouped them into the 5 categories. First is very low literacy disparity index, then we have the low, medium, high, and lastly we have very high literacy disparity index. In this last row, you will observe the Gadchiroli, Parbhani, Hingoli, Bid, and Jalna. Here, you will observe the large disparity gap in literacy. Same thing I have represented with help of the choropleth map of Maharashtra. In the conclusion and recommendation, the average gender literacy gap for the whole area, that Maharashtra state, it was 0.13. Very less gender literacy gap observed in the 8th district of the Maharashtra, that are the Mumbai, Mumbai Suburban, Nagpur, Amravati, Thane, Wardha, Akola, and Pune. Here we have the disparity rate less than 0.10. The year gender disparity gender literacy gap is too much less due to the awareness of the people as well as good education infrastructure and the facility are available in this. That is the main thing. In other hand, we have some district, just I mentioned Gadchiroli, Parbhani, Hingoli, Bid, and Jalna. Here we have much more literacy, the gap we observe with respect to the male and female literacy rate. The main reason are the custom of the early marriage, lack of parental motivation for the education, poor economic condition, domestic work for the girls, poor standard of living, and backwardness of the reason, that are the main reason. If you want to reduce the gender literacy gap of the literacy in this district, then government has to take special measure like opening of the school in the remote and the tribal area. That's very important. Government can provide incentive like a textbook, free uniform, scholarship, and the compulsory education for increase the enrollment of the girls school up to high school education, that is very important. And one thing is important, schools should be at the walkable distance. And government must formulate and adopt a long-term vision and national policy framework for the women's literacy and enrollment, empowerment, keeping in the mind a gender equality perspective. And there is also need to provision of effective adult literacy program with focus on school left out female above the age of 25 to 30. That is very important. So these are all about the our research paper. These are the references I have used for the this present study. Thank you very much.
Good morning, all of you. Myself, Mr. Ravindra Hande, Research Scholar, Department of Geography, Professor Ramakrishna More Arts, Commerce and Science College, Akurdi, Pune. Today, my topic is Spatio-Temporal Assessment of Selected Demographic Characteristics in Pune Administrative Division. I completed research work under the guidance of Dr. Arjun Musmade, sir. The disparity in spatial development of the region is the combined result of natural environment, resources and the existing demographic structure and spatial pattern of population in the region. Within the past two decades, vast changes have occurred in the many aspects of life in every country of the world. Perhaps the most significant has been recognition that rapid rate of population growth influences every sector of economic and social development. Worldwide interest in the population problems evolving from rapid population growth has been promoted by two major considerations in increasing concern about the relation between population growth and available resources and growing awareness that unrestricted population growth tends to impose a strong constraint on the standard of living, happiness and even survival mankind through this spilling consumption of the fixed quality quantity of resources. Maharashtra is the leading state in the India in every context and the study region. Pune division is comparatively well developed area and has very rich background of social, cultural, economic, agricultural, educational, industrial factors. In the concerned study, trying to put focus on the spatio-temporal changes in population. Study area. There are five districts in Pune Administrative Division, Pune, Satara, Solapur, Sangli and Kolhapur with total 58 tehsils. As per 2011 census, the total population was 2,34,49,049. This is map of study area. Objective of research work. The present study has been undertaken with the following specific objectives: to examine the spatio-temporal changes in effective demographic characteristics of Pune Administrative Division, to assess district-wise sex ratio, density, urban population and occupational structure of Pune Administrative Division of Maharashtra from the year 1901 to 2011. Database and methodology. This research work is based on secondary data sources. To realize this objective, data regarding selected demographic characteristics of Pune Administrative Division district is obtained from Census of India, Pune Administrative Division and Socioeconomic Aspect of Pune Administrative Division. To collect the data process, the district is taken as the component unit of analysis. Changes in the total population of Pune Administrative Division. During the period 1901 to 2011, there is a big changes in the population in all sort of administrative division. In 1911 to 1921, in this decade, there is decrease in population. whereas in other decades it increased. During 1981 to 1991, the rate of increase of population is high. District-wise population density in Pune administrative division, the density of Pune is high, where the Satara is low. From the year 1971, Pune district density is increased. Sex ratio in 1991 is more than 1000 as compared to Satara districts. There is increasing in sex ratio in 2011 census. In occupational structure, 2011 census referring to occupational structure of Pune district, in 2001 the rate of non-workers 55.63%. The growth in the total population of Pune administrative division shows declining trend from the year 2001 to 2011. As per the year 2001, the density of population was highest in Pune districts, followed by Kolhapur districts. As per the year 2011, the Pune districts was having highest population density with 603 persons per kilometer of area, whereas the Sangli district had lowest population density. Rain shadow region of Satara and Sangli district, well as the drought prone region of Solapur district, has low density population. The sex ratio was highest in Satara district throughout the decades, but from 2001 to 2011, it shows a declining trend from 995 to 988. There were total 44.37% working population in the Pune administrative division and a major portion of population. Conclusion: the research of the population structure reveals that in the case of most of aspects of the population structure, only the central economically developed belt shows the positivity, otherwise that western hilly belt and the eastern drought prone area shows negativity, with the few expectation like Haveli, Mahabaleshwar, Solapur and Pandharpur. This kind of uneven nature of working population is a major hurdle in economic development of the study area. Urbanization is an important indicator of the economic development of any region, and it also indicates the growth of secondary and tertiary sector. Thank you.